Thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Hear my teaching, O my people. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old, which we have heard and known, and such as our forefathers have told us, that we should not hide them from the children of the generations to come, but show the honor of the Lord, his mighty and wonderful works that he has done. He made a covenant with Jacob and gave Israel a law, which he commanded our forefathers to teach their children, that their posterity might know it, and the children which were yet unborn, with the intent that when they came up, they might show it to their children, that they might put their trust in God and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments, and not be as their forefathers, a faithless and stubborn generation, a generation that did not set their heart aright, and whose spirit did not cleave steadfastly to God. Like the children of Ephraim, archers carrying bows, who turned back in the day of battle. They did not keep the covenant of God, but would not walk in his law, but forgot what he had done and the wonderful works that he had shown them, marvelous things he did in the sight of our forefathers, in the land of Egypt, even in the field of Zoan. He divided the sea and let them go through. He made the waters to stand in a heap. In the daytime he led them with a cloud, and all the night through with a light of fire. He split the hard rocks in the wilderness and gave them drink in abundance, as out of the great deep. He brought waters out of the stony rock, so that it gushed out like the rivers. Yet for all this they sinned more against him, and provoked the Most High in the wilderness. They tested God in their hearts and demanded food for their craving. They spoke against God, saying, "Can God prepare a table in the wilderness?" Indeed, he smote the stony rock, so that water gushed out and the streams overflowed. But can he give bread also, or provide meat for his people? Then the Lord, when the Lord heard this, he was full of wrath. So a fire was kindled against Jacob, and there flared out fierce anger against Israel, because they did not believe in God and did not put their trust in his help. So he commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven. He rained down manna upon them to eat and gave them food from heaven. So mortals ate the bread of angels, for he sent them food enough. He caused the east wind to blow in the heavens, and through his power he brought in the south wind. He rained meat upon them as thick as dust, and feathered fowl like the sand of the sea. He let it fall among their tents, even round about their habitations. So they ate and were well filled, for they gave them what they desired. They did not deny themselves or craving. But while the food was yet in their mouths, the heavy wrath of God came upon them and slew the mightiest of them and struck down the young men of Israel. But for all this they sinned yet more and did not believe his wondrous works. Therefore he brought their days to an end in vanity and their years in trouble. When he slew them, they sought him and returned and inquired after God, and they remembered that God was their rock, and the Most High God was their Redeemer. Nevertheless, they flattered him with their mouth, and spoke deceitfully to him with their tongue. For their heart was not fixed on him, neither did they continue steadfast in his covenant. But he was so merciful that he forgave their iniquities and did not destroy them. Indeed, many times he returned his wrath. He turned his wrath away and would not permit his displeasure to arise, for he considered that they were but flesh, that they were even as a wind that passes by, passes away and comes not again. Many times they provoked him in the wilderness and grieved him in the desert. They turned back and tested God and provoked the Holy One of Israel. They remembered not his power, nor the day when he delivered them from the land, from the hand of the enemy, how he had wrought his miracles in Egypt and his wonders in the field of Zoan. He turned their waters into blood so that they might not drink of the waters. He sent flies among them, which devoured them up, and frogs to destroy them. He gave their fruit to the grasshopper and their labor to the locust. He destroyed their vines with hailstones and their sycamore trees with the frost. He smote their cattle also with hailstones and their flocks with hot thunderbolts. He cast upon them the furiousness of his wrath, anger, displeasure, and trouble, sending these destroying angels among them. He made a way for his indignation and did not spare their soul from death, but gave their life over to the pestilence, and smote all the firstborn in Egypt, the firstfruits of their strength in the dwellings of Ham. But as for his own people, he led them forth like sheep and carried them in the wilderness like a flock. He brought them out safely, and they did not, and they were not afraid. He overwhelmed their enemies with the sea and brought them within the borders of his holy land to his mountain, which he obtained with his right hand. He cast out the nations before them and caused their land to be divided among them for an inheritance, and made the tribes of Israel to dwell in their tents. But they tested and displeased the Most High God and did not keep his testimonies, but turned their backs and fell away like their forefathers, twisting aside like a broken arrow. For they grieved him with their hill altars and provoked him to displeasure with their images. When God heard this, he was full of wrath and utterly rejected Israel, so that he forsook the tabernacle at Shiloh, even the tent that he had pitched among them. He delivered the ark into captivity and his glory into the enemy's hand. he gave his people over to the sword and was angry with his inheritance. Fire consumed their young men, and their maidens had no marriage songs. Their priests were slain with the sword, and their wounds made no lamentation. Then the Lord awakened as one out of sleep, and like a warrior recovered from wine, he drove his enemies backward and put them to a perpetual shame. He rejected the tabernacle of Joseph and did not choose the tribe of Ephraim, but chose the tribe of Judah, even the hill of Zion, which he loved. And there he built his sanctuary, like the heights of heaven, like the earth which he had established forever. He chose David his son and took him away from the sheepfolds, as he was following the ewes that were great with young. God took him that he might feed Jacob his people and Israel his inheritance. So he fed them with a faithful and true heart and guided them with skillful hands. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Job, beginning with the 13th chapter, the first verse. Behold, my eye has seen all this, my ear has heard and understood it. What you know, I also know. What I am not inferior to you, but I would speak to the Almighty and desire to argue my case with God. As for you, you whitewash with lies. Worthless physicians are you all. Oh, that you would keep silent, and it would be your wisdom. Hear now my argument, and listen to the pleadings of my lips. Will you speak falsely for God, speak deceitfully for him? Will you show partiality toward him? Will you plead the case for God? Will it be well with you when he searches you out, or can you deceive him as one deceives a man? He will surely rebuke you if in secret you show partiality. Will not this majesty terrify you, and the dread of him fall upon you? Your maxims are proverbs of ashes, your defenses are defenses of clay. Let me have silence, and I will speak, and let come on me what may. Why should I keep my flesh in my teeth and put my life in my hand? Though he slay me, I will hope in him. Yet I will argue my ways to his face. This will be my salvation, that the godless shall not come before him. Keep listening to my words, and let my declaration be in your ears. Behold, I have prepared my case. I know that I shall be in the right. Who is there who will contend with me? For then I would be silent and die. Oh, only grant me two things, then I will not hide myself from your face. Withdraw your hand far from me, and do not let dread of you terrify me. Then call, and I will answer. Let me speak, and you reply me. How many are my iniquities and my sins? Make me know my transgression and my sin. Why do you hide your face and count me as your enemy? Will you frighten a driven leaf and pursue dry chaff? For you write bitter things against me and make me inherit the iniquities of your mouth. You put my feet in the stocks and watch all my paths. You set a limit for the soles of my feet. Man wastes away like a rotten thing, like a garment that is moth-eaten. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold, my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples, so that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud in heavens of Zion, ring out your joy, for the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Epistle to the Hebrews, beginning with the 4th chapter, the 14th verse. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast our confession, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. For every high priest chosen from among men is appointed to act on behalf of men in relation to God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He can deal gently with the ignorant and wayward, since he himself is beset with weakness. Because of this, he is obligated to offer sacrifice for his own sins, just as he does for those of the people. And no one takes his honor for himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not exalt himself to be made a high priest, but was appointed by him who said to him, you are my son, today I have begotten you. And he says also in another place, you are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to him who was able to save him from death, and he was heard because of his reverence. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation to all who obey. Being designated by God as high priest after the order of Melchizedek. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has regarded the lowliness of his own handmaiden, and behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm, he has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered and appointed his father, it was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of a body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, Lord. Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of eternal light, shed forth your unending day on us, who watch for you, that our lips may praise you, our lives may bless you, and our worship on the morrow give you glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God and Father of all, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess you and bless you. And men, women, and children everywhere love you and serve you in peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, so that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving of ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness. In righteousness, all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Mighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised, through your well-beloved Son, that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.